So in this video, I want to show you stuff about FM stations. And this is like the 10th or so take, because my camera was kind of trolling me, and I'm using the camera that makes a file that is on another camera, 280 megabytes. This camera, it makes it 600 plus megabytes. But my thoughts say, this today I may not use this camera today, and I may not use my tablet today. And so the other alternative would be the red camera with the like noise in it in the audio, and you will complain about the audio. So this is take number 10. Also, I haven't counted take number 5, 6, 7 and something in the 5 to 10 take. Okay, what I want to explain you, or what I attempt to explain you in this video is FM stuff. The frequency is wrong. You shouldn't see this frequency. It should be 500 kilohertz. So about FM. I do not know much about FM because I'm mainly into AM and shortwave, but I do know a little bit about FM. And in this video, I want to show you how everything works together and what frequencies you will see in the FM band and different and other stuff. Okay, so here I have a station. It's an example station, 100.2 megahertz. And what is your spectrum? If you have your transmitter and just want to transmit an audio signal like music or voice in mono, no problem. You will only use 0.02 to 15 kilohertz. So 0.02 to 15 kilohertz will only give you a small amount of bandwidth, but as far as I know, it's the double bandwidth. So if you have 15 kilohertz audio, you will need 13 kilohertz on the FM dial. You will take that space, 30 kilohertz. So the next thing is stereo. If you want to have a stereo signal, because your simple one transistor FM transmitter is only mono, if you have stereo, you will need much more bandwidth on the frequency dial because of the harmonics or stuff. Well, because of stuff. The next thing is RDS. RDS is what, if you have a car radio and tune in a station, you can see the station name, you can see some traffic information, maybe you can see what type of music is being broadcasted. All this stuff is shown with RDS. And there is special, which is in some countries still active, but I will come to that later, which is around 80 to 100 kHz, so I wrote 90 kHz. Here is a summary of the frequencies. 20 Hz to 15 kHz, you have audio. 19 kHz, you have your stereo carrier, and the stereo carrier mainly tells the transmitter or the radio, hey, is it going to be a stereo signal? Yes, if 19 kHz is there, or is it not going to be a stereo signal if 19 kHz is not there? And this is CW, so it's just a sine wave and no modulation on it. 38 kHz is the signal from left and right. You can hear it with single sideband receiver. 57 kHz, we have RDS data, which is FM, and 90 kHz special, it's also FM. Well, as our station already is using FM, you can't use FM again. But what they are doing is they're just using a narrowband FM signal, like you would get on your CB radio, where you don't have the hi-fi sound from the FM stations, you only have a very limited, like phone quality sound. And if you do this like that, it will work. Okay, I have a station tuned in here, a local station, very strong signal, around 1 kilometer distance to a 100 watt transmitter from here. And it does deliver stereo. As you can see, it's telling ST, which stands for stereo. And I'm tuning my receiver here, or I have to show you this, because I'm using a converter. So here's my radio. It puts out 0 to 100 kilohertz. Because this radio can, some other radios can't do it, but some radios can put out really high audio frequencies on the headphone plug. And here I have my converter, which I've written with K, because it's written with K in German. And the converter makes 500 kHz, adds it, and on the output we have 500 to 600 kHz. For example, if we would have 10 kHz here from the radio, you would get 510 kHz. And video, you just look at the last two numbers on the display, 00. They will change, but that's the frequency we are tuning in. We are not tuning in 500 kHz, we are tuning in 19, 38, and 57, and 90 kHz in this video. Okay, now let's start with the first thing. As I said, we have this FM station here, which is using a carrier signal for stereo. So if I tune my receiver to 19 kHz and crank up the volume, you can hear that there is a signal. See? There is a signal, and if I turn down the volume on the radio, if I turn it down, it's gone, turn it up, you can see it's there, but it's interrupted by the voice and music. Well, this is due to my simple circuit here. Usually it wouldn't be disturbing like this. So now watch, I decrease the volume because otherwise we have very loud noise. I now change the station to 105.7, where happens to be a news station. So this is, let's tune in, see if it scans. It will find a new station, and I can demonstrate that to you.
Für ganz individuelles Lernen.
Mangahai arbeitet mit einer
so as you can see, the station here, well, when I was turning the radio, I pushed the button, which I didn't want to push, but you could see on 105.7, there basically is a radio station. And the radio station is about talk and news. And it does not require a stereo signal, hence we have no carrier signal on 19 kHz. So the next thing, as I'm untuning it already, is what I want to show you, is 38 kHz. I say that on 38 kHz you will have the audio from left and right, and you can receive it with a SSB receiver. My receiver can receive SSB, but now let's turn on this. So I'm using a FM transmitter, which makes a stereo signal. And as you can see, as it turned on, we have our 19 kHz carrier signal again. So I'll turn up the volume a little bit. If I go down with the volume on the radio, see? So we have 19 kHz from our FM transmitter. And now I go on 38 kHz. And switch to single sideband on USB, and therefore I have to change the switch to middle position. And now watch what happens if I push play. So as you can hear, on single sideband, like amateur radio, on 38 kHz on the radio band, you have your signal, if you have a stereo broadcast, you have the left and right signal combined at that frequency. Let's do it again. So in theory, this would be a way to get a single sideband signal. If you mix it to another frequency and amplify it, you could broadcast it on single sideband. So the next thing that I want to show you, as we just saw the 38 kHz single sideband left and right carrier, which is hidden. I mean, from your radio you can only hear from your speaker, but these are the frequencies the radio is working with internally. On 57 kHz we can see RDS, so better hear RDS, but I can tell you, I do not know why, but it does work very bad. Maybe I can get it that you can hear it, sorta, but it's working really bad. On Shangu's video it worked great, so... As you can see, if I turn up the volume, let's turn down the volume. If I turn up the volume, you can see that there is a carrier, but you can't really hear it too good. You can hear it if I tune to 52. Hear it, the sound. That is RDS. I don't know why it's in 52. It should be on 57. But you can hear it. That's RDS. So it is not the static, not the noise. The radio is getting a clear signal, it's getting a clear data signal, since RDS means radio data system. So the radio is getting a clear data signal. This one doesn't have RDS, but on your RDS radio you would read the station name now. Okay, so this is about these things. The next thing that I want to show you is the FM transmitter. And now I can finally push the button and show you this, because here I have... it's on the frequency. Here I have this transmitter. So this is a one transistor, better not ask, cheap FM transmitter. And it works for the demonstration purpose. It's very weak. I had to add a small antenna. And yeah, what I want to show you now is I have my signal generator here. And what the signal generator will do, if I turn it on, it will boot up. And if it's booted up, it will broadcast, or better, generate a 19 kHz signal. The 19 kHz signal from my signal generator goes, if you follow the wire, goes into the FM transmitter. As you can hear, some speech, but ignore it. Now I have put my radio again on stereo. So the radio is on stereo. And if there would be a stereo signal, the radio would show stereo. But currently we're just having... I'm just having my one transistor FM transmitter, which does not transmit a stereo signal. But now I'm feeding in 19 kHz into my FM transmitter via the signal generator, and watch what happens. Well, nothing. Because I'm filming it, nothing happens. But usually, well, there's also... Oh, there we go. I'm sorry that you couldn't see it that good, because this contact here, the nut that holds it, is loose, and so there's no ground connection. Let's do it again. So with the signal generator turned off, no stereo. I turn it on, and you can see it. or should see it as soon as it boots up. Here we go, 19 kilohertz, and the radio says stereo. And if I go to my receiver now and tune in 19 kilohertz, I make it that you can hear static. And now let's see, 19 kilohertz on my receiver. See, 19 kilohertz, radio sees it's stereo, receiver says 19 kilohertz. So this is how a stereo, at least the recognition that the radio knows it's stereo or not, this is how it works. And now I would push pause again, which I did a few times, and then the camera decided to not continue the video when I was at the 10 minute mark, because I have to prepare some stuff now. But I will try to do that with one hand, which is very not nice, but I do not want to make this video over and over and over again, because this is like the, as I said, fifth plus take, and it's getting late, and I need to tidy up my room and work tomorrow and stuff. So what I have here is following. I have two signals. This is special, because in some countries, at least USA or so, you can order a station on a station. So you have your normal FM station, and if I push play here, now it works.
Test aufnahme.
So see, I've connected my voice recorder to my transmitter, and you can hear this. Push play.
Test aufnahme.
You can hear test aufnahme. So this is what you would usually hear on your radio. But there is a hidden signal on the radio. You can hear it very silent from the speaker, but on a professional station and not this shown together in a few minutes circuit, you wouldn't hear it. You would just hear your modulation, which would be, for example,
test aufnahme.
Okay, so now watch what happens if I connect the audio output from my transmitter. So the transmitter transmits to the radio, and the radio audio output goes to the mixer. Currently it's set on loudspeaker, but if I set it to headphone, it will put the signal from my oscillator here, which is 90 kilohertz, onto my communications receiver. And now watch, I switch it over. And you can hear it. And now I push play. You can see the LED, it's playing. You can see it does interfere a little bit. But as you can see, now we are on 19 kHz and using FM. On my normal radio signal, if I go back to speaker, you can't really hear it. You can hear it very silent, but if I push play here,
test aufnahme.
You can hear your normal stuff. You can hear a normal radio program, but as you can hear, it's silent. Usually you wouldn't hear this second thing, but this is what special means. So some people order the frequency. I've seen a Chinese radio station ordering the frequency, and then you can buy special radios that have this additional receiver capability, and then you can hear on a normal radio station's frequency, you can hear suddenly a different radio station on it frequency. But this additional station has very bad quality, like telephone quality, because they have to limit the bandwidth. Why can people buy this? The reason is very simple, it's cheap. So if you want to broadcast over an official station, oh, it's very expensive. But if you want to order the special 90 kilohertz, for example, 90 kilohertz frequency, you can actually buy it for rather low money amount. Okay, so this was my video about FM stuff. I know it's not really that good, and I'm not really into this FM stuff. I'm more into shortwave and medium wave, as is sure recognized by my videos. But I hope this gave you a short or small overview of what's going on the FM band and how complex a signal from a professional transmitter is compared to a cheap DIY one transistor FM transmitter, which broadcasts only in mono. Okay, thanks for watching. Have a nice day. And after this video, now I have to make the German part. So another 15 minutes of video. And yeah, okay, best regards, Stefan, and thanks for the comment with that says I'm a teacher and stuff. I really appreciate that. Best regards, Stefan.